cheer. Children are laughing, there's lights on the trees, everyone's happy except for me. Folks go out to parties, folks having fun. I want to blow my brains out, get me a gun. Christmas is here and I should feel swell, but I'm crying in my room and I feel like hell. What should I do? Mr. Faber, you're in big trouble. You gotta get out of New Jersey. But I know exactly what you're talking about because last Christmas I, for old Sam, was so depressed, I thought I was gonna die. So I decided to treat myself to a real special snappy time. So I got all dressed up and I went to this high-class, fancy-schmancy restaurant called Elaine's. It's one of those places where everybody who's anybody goes to eat Italian food. Well, between you and me, Roseanne, I like Elaine's because you get to see a lot of famous celebrities with a little bit of spaghetti sauce right here. And if they don't wipe that spaghetti sauce off right away, it gets all dry and hard and crusty, you know, like a blotch. And then when they open their mouth, the blotch separates, and when they close it, it goes together. And then they open it, and then it comes back, and then it starts to flake up a little bit, and then a little bit more flaking up and everything, and then it's gone! But anyways, I was sitting there reading the menu, when what comes out of the bathroom but Princess Lee Radziwill. You know that classy lady that no one's really sure where she's a princess, huh? Well, she was dressed up like a doll in this slinky, basic black dress, and she's got those skinny little arms, and she's got a lot of expensive jewelry hanging off them and everything. But then I noticed that Princess Lee had a little teeny tiny piece of toilet paper sticking to the bottom of one of her Gucci shoes. Listen to this. She was just walking around, up and down, that little piece of toilet paper trailing along behind her wouldn't fall off. And the more she walked, the dirtier it got. And then things started sticking to it, like a fuzz ball, a hair, a gum, a book. There was even some fettuccine alfredo in the romaine lettuce. Let me tell you that I, Rosanna, started to lose my appetite. So I yelled, "Hey, Princess Lee, take that toilet paper off your shoe. What are you trying to do, making me sick?"
What are you trying to do, make me sick? What are you trying to do? Roseanne, get back to the point.
Well, Jane, it's always something. Just goes to show you, if it isn't one thing, it's another. Either you're depressed at Christmas time or you've got a piece of toilet paper hanging on your shoe. But Jane, even though you yell at me and you say that I make you sick all the time and everything, I got you this nice little Christmas gift.
Aww.
It's a fruitcake.
I don't know what to say. I don't know what to say. Oh!
Oh, just shut up and eat the cake. And Mr. Faber, you pathetic person from New Jersey, I didn't forget about your problem. But Mr. Faber, you gotta take the bad with the good. It's just like that holiday life passed on down to me by my grandmother. Oh, just throw that hair away. The cake still tastes good. Just like that holiday advice passed down to me by my grandmother, Nana Rosanna Down. She used to say, life is just like a fruitcake. When you look at it, it's rich and sweet, with sugar and spices, it tastes good, and really warms up your appetite and everything. But when you look at it a little bit closer, it's got those weird little green things in it.